All right, my name is Vidram, and in this video I will be talking about how to install pycaret, the latest version 3.0, on your Windows machine or on a Google Colab. Okay, so these are the steps, and we already said that the most efficient way of installing pycaret is through a virtual environment. The reason is that pycaret comes with lots of dependencies, lots of packages, and you want to have a clear installment of all these packages with the proper version at a separate environment. You don't want to mess it up with your other packages or the later version of the Python that you have installed in a computer. Okay, so if you have already installed Anaconda, you can skip and go to the next step. If not, you can follow this link or simply open your browser and search for Anaconda Python. Anaconda Python. And the first link should take you to the Anaconda distribution. Simply click on it, and if you're on a Windows machine, the 64-bit, it's gonna automatically detect it, and you have to go ahead and click on download. Okay. I already have Anaconda installed on my computer, so I'm not gonna install it again, but for you, you can wait for it to be installed. It's a relatively bulky software. And you have to just click on it and then follow the steps. The steps should be pretty straightforward. Okay, then when you have Anaconda installed, you can go ahead and open an Anaconda prompt shell. But before that, let me show you the documentation for pycaret. So if I do pycaret documentation, you can go to the GitHub. And then, so here is the official documentation. So for the installation, basically it says that the 3.0 is available. You can install it by pip install --pre and pycaret, right? And so here are the steps for installation. And as you can see, you have to create a conda environment first, and then activate that environment and go ahead and install pycaret. Okay, so I'm gonna go ahead and create that environment first. So for that, I need to open an Anaconda prompt shell. So if you click on your Windows and then type Anaconda, so the first thing you see is Anaconda prompt. Go ahead and open it. Okay, so here is basically where we're gonna create this environment. Let me actually pull up the slides and then this together side by side. All right, I'm gonna minimize maybe here. I wanna see the steps, right? So if you want to see what are the environments that you already have, so again, if you are installing Anaconda from scratch, you don't have any environment except the base environment. But I'm going to show you the list of environments that I have. So I'm going to say conda environments list. So as you can see, I already have the base environment, and this is what I have already installed, pycaret 3. But this is the full version of pycaret that I have installed. In this video, I'm going to install the lighter version, which is going to be faster, and it depends on the less packages, so dependencies are fewer, so it can be installed faster. Okay, so let's go ahead and create that environment. I'm going to say conda create name. I'm going to call it pycaret lite, so that I know that this is not a full version. So let me call it pycaret 3 lite. Okay. And then make sure that the Python version is 3.8, and now press enter. Okay, so you can go ahead and say yes, because these are the packages that comes with the Python 3.8. So let's go ahead and do that. This should take, I don't know, maybe a couple of minutes depending on your RAM on a local computer, but it should be quite fast. All right. So now it seems that the environment has been created. You can check it out by simply looking at the list of the environment one more time. So now I should have three environments, the base, Python, the pycaret 3 and pycaret 3 lite, right? So this is, you can call it anything. No, you can call it pycaret, but I just want to keep track of the version of the pycaret that I have. So this is the full version, this is the lite version, okay? And we are going to install the lite version together. So now your next job is to activate the environment, right? Because right now it's in the base environment. You have to go ahead and activate the pycaret 3 lite version environment, okay? So conda activate pycaret we call it 3 light. Now, as you can see, we are in this environment. So the next step is to pip install our pycaret. And as you saw in the documentation, if you want to install the latest version, you can do pip install the --- pre-pycaret. So let's go ahead and do that. So I'm gonna say pip install pre-pycaret. So this is gonna install the lighter version of the pycaret. So if I press enter, even though it's supposedly light version, but it's gonna take some time, right? Again, depending on your internet speed connection and the RAM that you have on your computer, this may take up to 5 minutes. So I could go ahead and pause the video, but I think in the meantime that it's running, I can show you how you can install it on a Google Colab as well. Okay, so I'm gonna let this run and open another page. Let's go to Google Colab. So this is for those of you who want to run things on a virtual machine, right? So for example, you don't have Python installed on your computer and you wanted to, or for whatever reason, you are not using your own computer and you want to run things on a cloud, right? So Google Colab it provides you a virtual machine that you can literally run it anytime, anywhere. So I'm gonna go ahead and make a new notebook. If you're not familiar with Google Colab, you can watch my older videos that I talk about Google Colab. So just to search for Google Colab tutorials on my YouTube channel. All right, so I have to log in. So let me go ahead and log into my Google Drive. Okay, I paused the video and entered my credentials, and now I am in the Google Colab environment, right? So I can go ahead and rename this ipy notebook. I can call it pycaret. I want to make sure what is the version of this pycaret, so I'm going to call it pycaret version. Okay, so the way that you're going to install it on Google Colab is exactly the same thing. You have to add the exclamation and then do pip install pre-pycaret. And again, this is going to take some time, so maybe 3 to 5 minutes. And I'm going to let this run and go back to the installation on my local computer. So I'm showing you how to install it both on Windows on your local computer and on a cloud. So there's a difference between the two, and there's advantages and disadvantages. So the advantage of having pycaret installed on your local computer is that it's a one-time thing, right? You install it once and you're done with it. And every single time that you want to use pycaret package, you just simply load the package in your notebook or your VS Code Python, right? However, if you want to use Google Colab, every single time that you want to basically use pycaret, you have to install it from scratch. Because when you disconnect from Google Colab, so you have to install all the packages that you need to work with, right? So, and every single time, it means that every single time that you're disconnected from the server, it takes about 5 minutes. Okay, so let's go back to our terminal, the Anaconda terminal, and see if the pycaret is installed. Okay, on my local computer, it's not done yet. So these are the packages that are being installed under the hood. You can see the list of packages. Actually, if I go back to this pycaret installation, actually, let me go to the API documentation. So for example, I can go to API documentation for classification and then scroll up, go to installation. So this is, and make sure that this is the 3.0 version, you know, installation pycaret 3.0. And this is the documentation API. So basically here talks about what is available in the latest, how we can install the latest version. This is basically what we're doing. And if you want to see a list of hard dependencies, you can click here and navigate you to their GitHub account and see what is being installed behind the scenes. So these are what comes with a lighter version of the pycaret. And as you can see, LightGBM is already installed. But you don't have access to XGBoost, for example, in the light version. So what you can do, you know, if you want to use XGBoost as well, on top of this pycaret light version, you can go ahead and install XGBoost after that. Okay, So these are the plotting packages that are being installed. So Yellow Brick is one of the better machine learning visualization packages. And then as you can see, scikit-learn and scikit-learn, well, scikit-learn is already installed, right? And yeah, for time series, it's using sktime, which is very compatible with scikit-learn, and stats model under the hood. Okay, so these are the name of the dependencies. And now we can check if our, yeah, it seems that the installation on the cloud has been done. It took less than 3 or 4 minutes, I guess. But don't worry about this warning. You know, this says that basically these packages were previously important. If you want to use the one that was just installed, you have to restart the runtime. You can go ahead and restart the runtime. Okay. All right. Now, I want to quickly check what is the pycaret version that I installed. So I can say from pycaret.utils import version, and then see, check out what is the version. Hopefully we are going to see the 3.0, and that's it. Okay, so our pycaret is installed on Google Colab. So as you can see, the version is 3.0. So we are ready to use pycaret in Google Colab. And this is what I'm going to do in the next video when I showcase a regression. Now let's check back on our local computer and see if things are installed there as well. Okay. So on our local computer, it seems that it is taking more time. So I'm going to pause the video and then show you how the end product is going to look like. Okay, so it seems that the pycaret code and code light version installation is done. Now I need to just do the last step, and the last step is to create a notebook kernel. So if you're running your code in a VS Code, you don't need to do this step, but if you are familiar or used to notebooks, I encourage you to create a new kernel, and then each time you can run your pycaret kernel to make sure that it's using the pycaret Python under the hood, pycaret package under the hood, right? So let me actually go ahead and open this one. So this is the way, I'm going to show it to you what I mean by creating a notebook kernel if you're not familiar. So actually I'm going to show you what kernels I already have installed. So if I say, okay, Jupyter kernel spec, and then I want to see the list. So these are the kernels that are already installed. So let me show you the list. On my computer, there's only two now. So the first one is my Python 3, which comes by default if I want to open a notebook. The second one that I have created before is called pycaret 3. So I'm going to go ahead and make a new kernel and call it pycaret 3 Lite, right? So how do we do that? Yeah, I'm following this code. Okay, so let's do Python m ipykernel. We're going to install a kernel, and that kernel, we're going to name it. So here we have to make sure that this is your environment that you created. So we call it pycaret 3 Lite, I believe. Yeah, this is what we created, right? Pycaret 3 Lite. And now we need to specify a display name, right? So display name can be anything, you know, it can be anything different than pycaret 3 Lite, but for me the pycaret 3 Lite is informative, and I want to stick with that. Okay, so let's go ahead and run this line. So this is going to install a kernel. If I see the list of kernels, this should be added already. Okay, right now I have another kernel, so it's pycaret 3 Lite. So what does that mean? It means that now if I go ahead and open a Jupyter notebook or Jupyter Lab, if you wish, then, oops, sorry, what is it, Jupyter? So there was a typo, Jupyter Lab. Now it's gonna open your browser, and now you should see those three kernels. One was Python 3, the other one was, there you go, Python 3, pycaret 3 Lite, this is what I just created, and then pycaret 3 Full. Okay, so this is a Lite version. I can go ahead and click on it, and now I can check the pycaret version, which is already installed. So I'm gonna say from pycaret, the same code that we use in the Colab, Google Colab, pycaret utils well, actually, yeah, from this we're going to import version, and we're going to check out what is the version. Hopefully we get the 3.0. All right, there you go. So this is ready to be used for our next video, which I go over the pycaret regression showcase. So this is the local computer notebook. This is my Google Cloud. So the 3.0 is there, and we're going to utilize this latest version of the pycaret in the next video. All right. So before I leave, you know, because this is a common question that I get. So what if you install the pycaret the full version? Let me pull it up. So if you just go ahead and open, put the full version in the bracket, you should be able to install pycaret. On Windows, you should be able to install it without any errors. But I've seen students that are receiving or getting errors. If you get an error with the full version, don't worry, you can go ahead and install the light version like this. And you can go ahead and install the XGBoost manually, right? So for example, let me actually open another Anaconda prompt. So Anaconda prompt. And let's activate that environment. Activate pycaret 3 light. Who named it, I believe? Yep. Now I can do pip install XGBoost. So I can separate separately install XGBoost. And yeah. So now in this environment, I have all the machine learning models that I want. And I also added the XGBoost. Okay. So. And now in a notebook, I can go ahead and import XGBoost as well as, where is it? This one. I can import XGBoost as well as the pycaret and start working with that. All right, so we are ready to look at some examples in Python in our next video. Okay, take care, until then.